Hi, it's Colin Cowherd. I started The Volume to bring you some of the most authentic voices in sports. While you're here, make sure you hit subscribe. Thanks. Obviously, people are linked to me because I'm in the business of having strong opinions. I don't hold back, and I'm not ever terribly concerned how my opinions land for you. I have a right to an opinion. You have a right to an opinion on my opinion. And that's where it ends. Baker Mayfield had his worst professional game, standalone national TV game over the weekend. And I do believe that Andrew Berry, the GM, a really smart, respected guy, has already made his decision on Baker Mayfield. I think they're going to go after Derek Carr, Deshaun Watson. They'll make a run on Russell Wilson. But I just don't think they think Baker is face of the franchise material beyond playing. And I'll give you a great example. Dak Prescott of the Cowboys and Baker Mayfield of the Browns have a lot in common because the Cowboys and Browns are essentially the same team. The Cowboys have five Pro Bowlers this season. Cleveland has five Pro Bowlers this season. Two of the Cowboys Pro Bowlers are on the O-line. Two of the Browns Pro Bowlers are on the O-line. One of the Cowboy Pro Bowlers is a disruptive defensive player, Micah Parsons. One of the Browns Pro Bowlers is a disruptive defensive player, Myles Garrett. One of the Browns Pro Bowlers is an elite corner, Trayvon Diggs. One of the Browns Pro Bowlers is an elite corner, Denzel Ward. Both are really built around the run game. Zeke and Tony Pollard, Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt. Both have star volume veteran receivers, great route runners, Amari Cooper and Jarvis Landry. Both, as aforementioned, elite corners, Trayvon Diggs, Denzel Ward. Both have standouts at left tackle who have missed games this year, Tyron Smith and Jedrick Wills. Both have tremendous rookie linebackers, Micah Parsons. Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah for the Browns is not as lively athletically as Micah Parsons, but both serve the same purpose, a hyper-athletic rookie linebacker. Both have above-average defenses, offensive-minded head coaches, charismatic billionaire owners. They're on high-profile, often-discussed teams. The difference is Dak Prescott has much better judgment. There is no police video in college running from cops. There is no constant agitation, calling out his medical staff, talking about turmoil between he and the coaches, which doesn't exist. Baker did that 2 weeks ago. Just look at their off-field judgment and look at their podium judgment and look at their playing judgment. They're essentially both playing for the exact same team. The difference is Dak's judgment is better. He's completing this year 69% of his throws. Baker, 62. That's judgment. One has 29 touchdowns, 10 picks. That's Dak. Baker has 15 touchdowns, 11 picks. One has a passer rating over 100. That's Dak. One has a passer rating mid-80s. Both quarterbacks essentially are given the same opportunity. The more mature quarterback, the smarter quarterback, the quarterback with the better self-awareness since college, is flourishing, and the other is floundering. Baker is constantly looking to prove everybody wrong. He is a risk taker in his private life. I'll leave some of those details out, although I know them. The police video is what we've both seen. Baker is a risk taker at the podium, saying things that are not necessary. He is a risk taker more than Dak on the field. And the truth is, in both Baker and Dak Prescott's situations, very similar, neither needs to be a risk taker. This is a run-first operation in both Cleveland and Dallas. The difference is Dak understands it. Dak audibles out of trouble. Dak puts out fires. Baker starts them. And so we have a comp for Baker. It's Dak. Look at the Pro Bowlers. Look at the basis, the foundation, the strength of the team. I don't think I'm tough on Baker Mayfield. I think I'm brutally honest. I think Dallas waited and waited on Dak because he was not a spectacular arm talent, but ultimately made the decision to sign him up long-term for the big bag because of his intangibles. I think Cleveland is waiting, waiting, and waiting on Baker because he isn't a big-time arm or athletic talent. He won't get any bag due to his lack of intangibles. So I was talking to an executive this weekend, and he was talking about the fact the Jets and the Giants don't have a single Pro Bowler, and the Rams and the Chargers have a combined 10. And he said, you know, there's a reason, this executive said, Los Angeles for an executive is a reward. You live by the beach. You get the sunsets. You get the Mediterranean climate. You get a Stan Kroenke. You get a bus family. You get the Dodgers ownership. There's a lot of really good owners in Los Angeles, and the quality of life is high. Now, it's expensive, but he was saying one of the things that's not discussed about the Jets and the Giants is New York is harder than Los Angeles. The weather's harsher. You can live within 8 minutes of SoFi Stadium in a nice suburb in Los Angeles. It's harder in New York. The taxes, the weather, the people, the intensity, the media, the drives to work. And this NFL executive was saying, listen, if you put all four jobs on the market, Rams GM, Chargers GM, Jets GM, and Giants GM, he says, regardless of what you may or may not think of the Spanos family, the Rams and the Chargers would be the first two jobs people want. That beautiful stadium, non-meddling owners, perfect weather, lots of places, nice communities, fairly close drive to work. You can get a backyard. You don't have to take the train. The media is not as harsh. The fans are not as harsh. In Los Angeles, he was saying, people are distracted. The beach, the weather, the proximity to wine country, to Laguna. The whole point was the Giants and the Jets are not necessarily getting elite people in their front offices. Was Dave Gettleman an elite candidate? I like Joe Douglas, but was he an elite candidate? So you start looking around. Why can't the Giants and the Jets get it together? And why are the Chargers and the Rams really fairly jammed with elite talent? Better scouts, better GMs, better front offices. And I think this is not necessarily a shot at New York. It's a reality of New York. I lived on the East Coast for 10 years. I really enjoyed it. But it's intense. You have to commit to New York. You have to convince your wife, okay, are you ready for the intensity of New York? Los Angeles, you ask much different questions. Where do you want to live near the beach? And I think Los Angeles, for people of high income, is viewed as a reward. That's why Los Angeles is filled with New Yorkers, and New York is not filled with people from Los Angeles. Because if you can make it in Los Angeles, there's no reason to live in New York. And this has all been exacerbated by COVID. And whereas in Los Angeles, you have more sun, you have more space, you have backyards, you have access to beaches. It's an easier life in the middle. I mean, we're seeing it now with Omicron. Like, it is spreading like wildfire, again, overwhelmingly in cold weather climates. And it was just interesting to have this discussion with somebody who has been in the hiring business in professional sports. And he said, there's a reason that in Los Angeles, look at the number of stars. He said, just start counting all the star athletes. Why? Their agents like to push them here. Their agents like to visit there. It's just a win. It's considered a reward if you end up at the end of your career staring at the sunset in Manhattan Beach or Pacific Palisades or Malibu or Santa Monica. It's a reward. You won. New York, you have to buy into the intensity of the media and the weather and the commutes and the fans and the backlash. And I think as sports continues evolving, people have more options. Athletes have never had more options. College athletes transfer portal. Our parents didn't have these options. Our grandparents certainly didn't have these options. But for rising stars and executives, they do. And they're choosing overwhelmingly LA over New York. It's easier. They're both expensive. One is significantly easier.